I guess the most exciting thing is that on any given day, you never know what new directions you're going to be moving into with research. I mean, that's the nature of science, is although we come in with certain ideas about how things work, oftentimes that's not how it works. We have some epidemiological evidence from human studies that certain foods and certain lifestyle factors affect colon cancer risk. We're trying to understand specifically how that may occur, and hopefully by knowing more about the specific mechanisms, we can be more successful in both preventing and treating cancer. And so having shown that this compound from broccoli sprouts was acting through this epigenetic mechanism, we then simply gave human volunteers broccoli sprouts, one cup of broccoli sprouts, like 68 grams, with a bagel and cream cheese, and then we measured this enzymatic activity and showed, just as we had seen in our cultured cells and just as we had shown in our mouse models, even in human beings consuming a whole food, we could measure these epigenetic changes. So the immediate impact in terms of how the endowed professor would impact my own research is that it allows me to bring in a grad student. And I'm making it clear to the student who gets this isn't just an ordinary, everyday graduate fellowship. This is a competitive one, and it's come specifically from this endowed position. Of course, the research that we're doing has a large number of international ties. I've worked in Tokyo at the National Cancer Center. I learned completely new scientific ideas, getting to meet new people, discuss new concepts. And those ideas were brought back to my lab, and they formed the basis of new research. And because of that, we got new funding. So that really is something very real about scientific research is, you know, I may get up today and a whole new research direction will happen. And 10 years from now, my lab will be focused on that whole new area. Mm-hmm.